The petroleum Ridewagen is generally recognised as the first ever internal combustion petrol-fueled motorcycle. And of course, once people started building bikes, it didn't take long for them to want to race each other. The first recorded bicycle race was said to have taken place in Paris in 1868, and the sport became one of the events in the first modern Olympic Games held in Athens, Greece in 1896. As racing bicycles or motorbikes was relatively new, there was nowhere to compete them on except public roads. The turn of the century saw an explosion in sport and motorsports in general, and competitive cycling was hugely popular at venues such as Madison Square Garden in the United States, while in Europe, it was events like the Tour de France, first held in 1903, which caught the public's imagination. On four wheels around this time saw the birth of rallying, with many city-to-city races such as the Paris-Bordeaux-Paris Rally and the Monte Carlo Rally soon after. Speeds had now far outstripped the safe limits of dusty highways, thronged with spectators, and open to other traffic, people, and animals. There were numerous crashes and many deaths and injuries, which led to some European governments, in particular in France where motorsport had effectively begun, banning racing unless they were held on closed roads. There were similar moves in Britain, where concerns were also raised about the increased speeds in motor vehicles, yet the British authorities, which at that point controlled Ireland, allowed unrestricted racing to take place in the Emerald Isle. This was due to the Gordon Bennett Cup, first run in France in 1900, and when British driver Selwyn Edge won in Austria 2 years later, it meant the event had to be held in his home country. Yet, due to the imposed speed restrictions on mainland Britain, it took place in County Kildare. That was 1903, and the following year, the authorities in the Isle of Man, in particular King Edward VII's representative on the island, Lord Raglan, had pushed through legislation allowing racing to take place. And so began the TT. That was because the British team had nowhere to trial and select the drivers who would represent them, so they turned their eyes once again across the Irish Sea. Many people nowadays regard the Isle of Man as the home of road racing, and the first course in 1904 measured just over 51 miles in length and was contested by cars. It began on the edge of Douglas before heading down to Castletown, then north to Ballacrane, and from there it went to Sandygate and across to Ramsey and over Snaefell Mountain. The following year, motorbikes were introduced, but during testing, they struggled to climb the mountain, so the course was shortened, with competitors turning right at Ballacrane and heading back to Douglas. Other similar circuits were proving popular, in particular the Targa Florio on the island of Sicily in Italy. By 1905, the British had withdrawn from the Gordon Bennett Cup and turned the trials for the event into the first ever tourist trophy meeting, using the mountain section again. 12 months later, the southern part of the course had been removed. The introduction of the first motorcycle TT came about following a meeting of the Auto Cycle Union in January 1907, and just over 3 months later, the St. John's course was used for the first time.